For all those times you stood by me, for all the truth that you made me see, for all the joy you brought to my life, for all the wrong that you made right, for every dream you made come true, for all the love I found in you, I'll be forever thankful, baby. You're the one who held me up, never let me fall. You're the one who saw me through, through it all. You were my strength when I was weak. You were my
I'm good, I'm good. I'm gonna give me some flowers for my lady. All right, well, welcome to our club. Sending this information to you. All right, can you give me your first name? My name's Twan. Twan, yeah, okay, yeah. All right, and Twan, what's your last name? I don't have a last name. You don't have a last name? No. Okay, it's not for me anyway. Well, that's all right, it's for a lady of mine. Oh, who are the flowers gonna go to? It's gonna be for a beautiful lady by the name of Sophie. Sophie, oh yeah. Oh. She gonna be mad. Now tell me what you like to order.
Well, I like to order. I want to order a dozen of red roses every single day to be delivered over there to my baby Sophie. Okay?
Every day?
Yeah, can you do that? Can you handle that?
Yeah, I can handle it. Okay. So one dozen roses.
Every single day till I tell you to stop.
Okay. All right, I got it. All right, so why don't we set it up for a week? How's that?
Set it up for a month.
A month?
That's right, a month.
Oh. Well, now, you know that's going to cost you a little bit of money.
Oh, money ain't a thing right here, baby.
Okay.
Ain't a thing for what I want.
Well, right now, we at $1,650.
Oh,
can you handle that?
That's right there.
Oh. Well. Well.
So just make that happen for me, okay?
All right. I hear you.
Appreciate it.
All right,
now.
You.
I'm going to holler at you.
Not a problem.
All right.
All right. Bye now. Do come back again.
Smith.
Can you mind if I look?
Sure, I don't mind.
Okay, hold on, I'll be right back.
Oh my goodness. Are those for me?
Miss Sophia Smith?
Yes.
Yes, they are, ma'am.
Oh my goodness. Twan, Antoine sent these?
Yes, he did.
Wow. Wow. You're mine.
We'll be right back.
matures with age, the days become longer, times move slower, and seasons begin to change, revealing to us the ups and downs of life. Somehow, without planning, our hearts begin to search for true companionship.
That's nice. God, I am so confused. I mean, first he sent me roses, then he sent me like a wardrobe. He still wants to take me to Vegas. Lord, your word says, the blessings of the Lord make it rich and add it no sorrow. And I ain't sorry. I am not sorry. I'm like ecstatic. I never had a man write a poem for me. Send me clothes, flowers. Antoine act like he done matured a little bit. Is this you, Lord? Are we soulmates? Maybe we soulmates. I don't know, but I'm gonna have to call Antoine and really see what's up with him, because you know, he's doing a good job right about now.
How are you?
How are you?
I'm good.
What's up?
Well, you know how the Bible says that if we have a problem with our brother, then we're supposed to come to them.
Girl, who you got a problem with?
Well, you know, what? Just, you slipping.
I'm slipping?
Yes.
What do you mean by that?
You know, it's like all this gossip about you and, you know, just...
What gossip? The other day you told me that somebody said they saw me kissing Antoine.
Then the baby stuff and people are steady gossiping.
But I'm not.
And you know, Amber is like a baby saint and she
claims
she's seeing all
she the one that's gossiping?
I mean, I'm just saying.
No, she didn't see any of that because I didn't kiss him. I'm not going to Vegas. I'm not doing any of those things.
I just see a change in you. And I just, you know, I'm just a little scared for you.
You scared for me?
Yes. Because, I mean, you led me to the Lord, and I just feel like, you know.
I'm getting a little offended because I haven't done anything wrong.
I mean, what was up with the flowers and stuff?
I didn't tell him to buy me flowers.
I'm just saying.
I did not tell the man to buy me flowers, so that's something that he did. I just accepted them.
I just want you to be safe and careful because I don't trust Antoine at all.
I'm safe.
And I don't want him to like get you in a place where you begin to like backslide and stuff.
So you think I'm backslidden?
I didn't say that. I'm just saying.
Okay. You know, so many people are just all in my business and I ain't done nothing wrong.
That's because they love you.
It's not because you just said Amber was over back there gossiping.
I'm just
saying. She don't love me, she gossiping.
Good afternoon, Patty Kate.
Yes, my speak to my beautiful Sophie.
This is Sophie, who is this?
What's up, baby, how you doing?
Antoine.
You know it. Twan the man. What's happening?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good. How you like those flowers?
I was surprised. It was a wonderful surprise. Thank you.
Oh, you're greatly welcome. I mean, you're the queen of my eyes. You know, I only could give you but the best.
Did you just call me the queen of your eye?
Queen of my eyes, exactly.
Okay. What's up? How can I help you?
How can you help me? You can help me a lot. But first of all, I'm not going to be too long with you because I got some things I got to take care of. But I want to take you to your favorite restaurant.
You want to take me to my favorite restaurant?
Yes, to your favorite restaurant.
Okay. And when do you want to do that?
Let's go for it. What you doing tonight?
I got to go to church.
Church?
I have to go to church tonight.
Again?
Yeah, you can come.
How many times you go to church?
See, now you about to go way to the left.
Whatever, the favorite restaurant, wherever you want to go.
Yeah, you said you were going to take me to my favorite restaurant.
Exactly.
You remember what my favorite restaurant is?
Yes, I do.
Okay, well, we'll see.
Okay, all right. Okay, then, well, I'm going to holler back at you, okay?
Okay, no problem.
All right, my beautiful princess.
Okay, you have a good day.
All right.
Okay, bye-bye.
All right.
Come in.
I'm just relaxing here.
Oh, I'm a little nervous.
Don't be nervous. I don't bite.
Okay. Okay, I know. I wanted to meet with you because I have a question.
Mm-hmm.
I wanted to know if people can change. And should we give people second chances?
Well, God gives people second chances, but can you be a little bit more specific?
Well, there is someone from my past
mm-hmm.
who I used to date, and, you know, I got saved, and he's not, well, he said he's coming back to the church.
Okay.
And he's been kind of like being really attentive and really nice. He sent me roses, and I got, like, new clothes, and he sent me these shoes.
I like some boots, girl.
Thank you, I know.
I'm a boot girl myself.
Me too. So, he's being, like, extremely nice, and he said he's going to come to church.
Okay.
So,
are you asking me, can he change?
Yeah, can he change?
Well, there's several things, Sophia, that we would need to just look at. Firstly, when you say that someone of your past, what kind of someone was he in your past?
I wasn't saved when he was in my past.
Did you have a relationship with him?
Yeah, I did.
Okay. All right. And so now you are saved, and you've been saved how long?
For about 3 years now.
About 3 years. Mm-hmm. Okay. So you're a growing, maturing Christian.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. And has he ever been saved?
I really don't know. I don't think so.
Okay.
But he said he was going to come to church.
Okay, so he hasn't quite got to church yet.
Yeah, I ain't seen him yet.
Okay.
But he said he's coming.
All right. Well, let him come when he comes.
Okay.
But that will qualify him as not being saved.
Okay.
And I know that you've been saved long enough to know what the Bible says about this, which is for us not to be what?
Unequally yoked. Yes.
With unbelievers. So at this point, he is still an unbeliever. He might be a fine unbeliever, and there are some fine unbelievers.
Okay. Yeah,
but it's still with Mako, an unbeliever.
But it's no men in the church.
Well, there are a few men in the church. But agreeably, no, there's not a man for every woman. But this is the thing about God,
okay,
Sophia, that when it's your time for the man that God has for you,
mm-hmm.
he will appear. He doesn't have to be in the church.
Okay.
He might be on your job. He might be connected to somebody somewhere else.
You say he don't have to be in the church?
In other words, he doesn't have to be a member of your church, per se,
okay,
for God to put you. He needs to be saved.
You got my hopes up high a little bit.
There are other churches with plenty of men.
Okay.
Right? So yes. I'm saying he doesn't necessarily have to show up the way that you want him to show up. But that's the ideal way.
Okay.
That he just walks in the door of the church, and it happened to be the church that you go to. But God will set him at your side.
Okay.
The exact place and the exact way that he wants to do it. And we don't know how or when.
You cannot date him?
Not now. That would not be smart. That would not be wise. He's not saved. He's not saved. I understand that the woman in you loves the attention, and we don't want to ignore that.
Okay.
That's real.
Yeah.
And we can't ignore that. But as Christians and as saints, We live by the word of God. We make decisions to do what the Bible says, and we put our flesh under subjection. Because what I'm hearing is that he's appealing to the woman in you. He's okay. appealing to the side of us that wants to be loved, that wants to give roses, mm-hmm. that wants to have stimulation. Mm-hmm. But the bottom line is that at this point in his life and yours, it's not time and it would not be God, because he has not given his life to God. And let me say this, Sophia.
Okay.
Even if he comes to church, that doesn't make him a Christian. Okay?
Okay.
Coming to church doesn't mean that he gave his life to God. Many men come to church just long enough for women just like you to put your guards down and for them to go in and get exactly what they want.
Okay.
So you got to be smarter than that. Okay. And rely totally and completely on the word of God, because that is what we as Christians need as the absolute truth and the best way to go. Perfect and right.
Okay. So it's going to be hard, though.
It's going to be hard. Especially if he's fine. It's going to be real hard.
Can I keep the gifts?
Well, why don't you follow your own conviction about that?
Okay.
But, you know, most brothers aren't given a gift without expecting something in return. Especially the unsaved ones.
Okay.
You have to allow the Holy Spirit in you to guide you to what to do in this situation. But you got to be careful, girl.
Okay.
Because you don't even want to put yourself in a situation being alone with them, being in places and spaces where you're opening the door for just to slide and to slip. You don't want to do that.
Okay. That might be pretty hard.
Well, it's going to be hard, especially if you stand by the fire, boo.
Okay, well, I don't like
you this. Get burned, yeah, if you stay near the fire.
Okay. Oof, that's a lot.
But if you turn off the stove and the oven and get out the kitchen, you're going to be okay.
Okay. Yeah, Mama G said something like that the other day. Okay. Well,
okay.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
All right.
Yeah, thank you so much. I feel like I should give you an offering now.
Oh, no, that's okay. That one's free, baby. Okay. I've been there, done that.
Okay. Well, thank you so much.
All right. You're welcome.
Okay.
Hope to see you soon. Now, also,
yes,
there's a Wild Woman event coming up.
Oh, really?
You're going to be there? Love to see you there.
When is it?
It's in about a month or so.
Yeah.
If you have your email, you're on the list.
Okay.
We'll make sure you get it.
Yeah.
But we're going to be getting together. We'll talk about things just like this. This is the kind of stuff we deal with.
Okay.
Real life, real stuff, real talk.
Okay. Yeah, then yeah, I'll be there.
All right.
I'll be there. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
For all those times you stood by me, for all the truth that you made me see, for all the joy you brought to my life, for all the wrong that you made right.